Hello, welcome to this section. In this section, we are going to discuss about what is pre-cooled Linde-Hampson system used for gas liquefaction. Before explaining about the details of pre-cooled Linde-Hampson system, first let us see what is simple Linde-Hampson cycle used for gas liquefaction. The previous video, we already discussed about Linde-Hampson cycle. It consists of a compressor, a heat exchanger and a expansion device. If you refer this diagram, the medium entering into the system is M dot, that is medium entering into the compressor is M dot, and after the compression it is entering into a heat exchanger, then passing through a expansion device. And during the process, the quantity M dot F is liquefied, that is diverted into another location, and remaining quantity M minus MF is further returned back to compressor. So this is the schematic diagram for a Linde-Hampson cycle. And if you are attaching a pre-cooling cycle into this Linde-Hampson cycle, that is known as pre-cooled Linde-Hampson system. So let us see what is meant by pre-cooled cycle. Here I have shown this schematic diagram for a pre-cooled cycle. It consists of a compressor, a condenser, and an expansion device, and an evaporator. Evaporator is nothing but a heat exchanger known as pre-cooling heat exchanger. And if you refer this particular schematic diagram, it is operating as per vapor compression refrigeration principle. That is, we are using a refrigerant with a mass flow rate MR is entering into the compressor, then it is passing through a condenser. The condenser may be liquid cooled or a water cooled, and after the condensation that refrigerant is entering into expansion device where constant enthalpy expansion take place, then it is entering into an evaporator, and this cycle continues. Basically it is a vapor compression refrigeration cycle. If you are attaching this pre-cooled vapor compression cycle into a simple Linde-Hampson system, that is known as pre-cooled Linde-Hampson system, that is LH system with a pre-cooling arrangement added into it, that is known as pre-cooled Linde-Hampson system. Here I have given that total schematic diagram for a pre-cooled Linde-Hampson cycle. The bottom portion representing LH system and the top portion representing pre-cooling cycle. The combination is known as pre-cooled Linde-Hampson cycle. Then we need to think about what is the advantage we are getting while adding a pre-cooling cycle into Linde-Hampson system. If you refer the Linde-Hampson cycle that I have shown in the bottom portion, the temperature of the medium leaving the compressor WC1 that can be reduced with the help of a pre-cooling cycle. That is, the purpose of pre-cooling cycle is to reduce the temperature of the medium leaving the compressor WC1. If you do so, what is the amount of yield we can able to produce? That quantity is increased. Yield is nothing but what is the amount of gas is liquefied divided by total mass. So yield can be increased by adapting this particular arrangement. If you see the entire system, it consists of two portion, top portion, pre-cooling cycle, bottom portion, Linde-Hampson system. What is the amount of medium circulating through a pre-cooling cycle, that is known as M dot R, that is mass flow rate of a refrigerant. Basically it is a closed cycle. And what is the amount of medium entering into the compressor of a LS cycle, that is known as M dot. And M dot F is the quantity of the medium is liquefied. Remaining quantity M dot minus MF only returned back to compressor. And also there is a provision for supply the makeup fluid M.F. So the bottom portion is representing a open cycle and the top portion representing a closed cycle. So simply I can say LS cycle is a open cycle and pre-cooling cycle is a closed cycle. Then we need to see how we can represent the processes on a TS diagram. The process 1 to 2 representing a compression process under constant temperature condition that can be performed in compressor WC1, and 2 to 3 representing a pre-cooling operation that can be performed with the help of a pre-cooling heat exchanger, and what is the amount of the temperature after achieving the pre-cooling? That is known as pre-cooling temperature. That temperature is one of the important parameter in order to find the what is the amount of yield. In order to get that maximum result, we need to reduce the temperature of the pre-cooling as lowest as possible. Obviously, what is the amount of pre-cooling we can able to produce, or what is the amount of lowest value of temperature we can able to produce after pre-cooling, is depending upon what is the property of the refrigerant that is circulating through a vapor compression cycle, that is pre-cooling cycle. Then 3 to 4 is again, it is a constant pressure cooling process on the second heat exchanger, that is heat exchanger used in Linde-Hampson system. Then 4 to 5 is a isenthalpic expansion process. Then again heat gain take place while passing through G26, and 6 to 1 is reheating in a reheating heat exchanger. Then this cycle continues. We need to find out what is the yield we can able to produce with the help of this particular system. Yield means how much amount of mass is liquefied divided by total mass on the liquefaction cycle. So in order to calculate the yield, we are going to apply a energy balance in this particular control volume. The control volume what I have shown in a dotted line. In this control volume, mass is entering into the system with a different mass flow rate and mass leaving from the system with a different mass flow rate. If you see the entire schematic diagram, the major points on a Linde-Hampson systems are represented by the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, F, G, 6 and 1. So that is the cycle that representing a process on a Linde-Hampson system, that is represented at the bottom portion. And important points on the pre-cooling cycle, that is vapor compression cycle, that I have shown in the top portion are A, B, C, D and return back to A. If you do the energy balancing on this control volume, first let us see what are the medium entering into control volume. There is a refrigerant with mass flow rate MR, MR at D and M at 2. These all are the two medium entering into control volume. And what are the medium leaving the control volume? MR at A and M minus MF at 0.1 and MF at F. These all are the medium leaving from the control volume. So with the corresponding enthalpy value, we need to apply the first law of thermodynamics into this particular control volume. Then if you are applying the first law of thermodynamics into this control volume, what is the amount of energy entering into the control volume should be equal to what is the amount of energy leaving from the control volume. That is MR HDR plus M dot H2 equal to M dot R into HAR plus M minus M dot F into H1 plus M dot F into HF. Here H is representing specific enthalpy at a concerned points. And if you are rearranging the entire expression, we can say like M dot R HDR plus M dot H2 equal to M dot R into HAR plus M dot minus M dot F into H1 plus M dot F into HF. If you are rearranging the expression in order to get the value for yield, M dot F minus M equal to H1 minus H2 divided by H1 minus HF plus M dot R divided by M dot into HAR minus HDR divided by H1 minus HF. That is, here we got the expression for yield, that is M dot F by M in terms of enthalpy values and also the mass flow rate of the refrigerant that is circulating through the pre-cooling cycle. The term M dot R divided by M dot is denoted as small letter R. So finally, the yield is represented by the expression that I have given here. In this expression, it can be divided into two portions, first portion and second portion. The first portion representing the expression of yield corresponding to simple Linde-Hampson system. The second portion representing what is the additional yield we can able to attain by adding a pre-cooling system into Linde-Hampson system. So it is very clear that by adding a pre-cooling system into a Linde-Hampson system, we can able to increase the amount of yield. So that is the advantage what we are getting by adding a pre-cooling system into a Linde-Hampson system. So this entire cycle is known as pre-cooled Linde-Hampson system. This system can be used for liquefaction of different type of gases like helium, neon, nitrogen, hydrogen, etc. Ultimately, we can able to increase the yield by adopting this particular system as compared with the simple Linde-Hampson system.